Send me an email, drop me a text, stating point of view. Indicate precisely what you mean to say. You're sincerely wasting away. Give me your answer, fill in a form, mine forevermore. Will you still need him? Will you still feed him when Doug 64? Happy birthday, bro.
That's really nice. So if you see Hal, thank him, and I will too. You know his band is the Lost Tribe. Look for them around town. Let me just take a minute and thank all the people, because this is kind of a one-off and a first time, and it doesn't happen just because it was going to be a fun way to celebrate my birthday. I want to welcome you to the Savoy, and I want to acknowledge that tonight we're here on land that is the traditional territory of the Ute, Cheyenne, and Arapaho peoples, and we honor the elders past, present, and future, and recognize the ongoing exclusions and erasures of indigenous people. I want to give a big shout out to Megan Frank and her family, who've brought back so beautifully our neighborhood treasure, the Savoy, and thank you. And it's important that you know there's an exit at the back of the room. That's where you came in. And right there, if you can't see, there's an exit that way. So should you need a speedy exit, that's important to know. It's also important to know that you can come back here between September 28th and October 15th, when Theater Artibus is putting on their latest original theater production called The Pastisserie. The Pastisserie. It's about nostalgia. If you've seen their work, you know it's going to be awesome once again. So thank you to Megan for having us. I want to thank George Figgs from KGNU Community Radio in Boulder for providing the sound equipment in the mix tonight. There's KGNU information, sign-up stuff right in the back of the room. There's also a sign-up sheet. If you weren't the person who signed up for tonight and you want to get emails from us there or at the box office, we've been doing these in our living room for, this is our eighth season, and the list is growing, which is partly why you're here, and the list will grow if you get on it and come support live music in intimate settings. And I would just say that while this is twice as many people as we can fit in our living room, it still feels, you know, close and comfortable, and you know, you can always feel free to heckle the band as if you were in the living room. I know they won't mind. We also really always appreciate our friend Karen Marks, who met you at the door along with Maggie. We've had over, I think, 40 concerts in our living room, and Karen's been greeting people at most of them. So thank you, Karen. A big thank you to David Weihnacht and Catherine Carley, who have been hosting the pairs, and to David for photography and video. He's been at many of our shows, and we've got great photos to show for that. Thanks to Ben Cohen, who also happens to be a member of the Lost Tribe. These monitors that Ben lent us mean that the band can hear themselves and sing even more wonderfully. A shout out to the Flower Shop. That's F-L-O-U-R. They're a new business in the neighborhood. They bake those yummy cookies. If you haven't tried them yet, you really must. They're just delicious. So have a cookie during or after the show. You'll hear about this if you're on the email list. Thursday, July 31st, Guyon Gregory Long is a master drummer, storyteller, recording artist. It says August, yes. Thursday, August 31, Guyon Gregory Long is playing in the living room, and I'll just say it shouldn't be missed. And then some of you have seen Jill Sobule. Some of you have hosted Jill Sobule in your living room. Jill Sobule is from Denver. She's coming back to town for her Carson Elementary reunion. And while she's here, she reached out and said she'd like to play some more shows. These will be in Englewood, Greenwood Village area at the home of her mother's best friend. If you've not seen Jill Sobule, treat yourself. If you have, then you'll want to know that this one is on. The first one sold out. This one will be on August 28th. And then mark your calendars. We'll be celebrating Maggie's big birthday Saturday, October 14th, with the return of Molly O'Brien and Rich Moore. And that's supposed to be in our living room, unless we decided to change it to here. So check out fivepointslive.com for all that information. I want to thank Maggie and Jordy for always celebrating my birthday with me and being here tonight. There's Maggie. Thank you, sweetie. And I want to thank all of you for coming and making it possible to have music and community together this way. So the first time that I heard this band launch into a tune, I was immediately smitten by their voices, by their songs, and by the genuine qualities of the human beings who were singing those songs. And I've heard them in tiny showcase rooms. I've heard them in living rooms and clubs. And wherever I hear them, well, for one thing, they make it feel like a living room. And so that's why I'm glad you get to be here to enjoy and interact with them tonight. And I'm really thrilled because I'm looking forward to seeing them perform for thousands on the main stage at the Rocky Mountain Bluegrass Festival in Lyons at Planet Bluegrass on Sunday. Yeah. So right now, I'm delighted to welcome to the stage of the Savoy from London, Ontario, Canada, the Pairs.
Hello. Oh yeah, the kindest heckling begins. So glad to be here. Happy birthday, Doug.
We're overjoyed to be a part of the celebration of Doug.
How you doing? Good. We're going to start with a song called Easier to Leave, but we do hope you'll stay.
Easily sleeping.
Thank you very much. Thanks so much. I think that's funny that we're going to play this next song called Fallen for you. And it kind of is the reverse. That first song that we played, Renee wrote when she was in a bickering match with her former partner about a tent they had outside. And
kind of falling out of a 7-year relationship.
Yeah,
I just want to quickly add that you said Fallen for you, and it sounded like that was the title of the song, but it's called Fallen.
Yeah.
But I thought that was cute.
Thanks, Hill. Well, this next song is before the bickering. It's during the Fallen. Falling.
For you.
For you.
Are you ready?
Watching me.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Happy birthday, Doug. By the end, we just take every pause to say happy birthday to Doug. By the end, he's like, Jesus.
You know what, though? Backstage, I realized Doug is a Leo. Yeah. I'm also a Leo, so I feel like I understand. And if it was me, I'd love it.
Okay. Okay. Good to know.
So I don't know, Doug. I hope you're loving it.
And Maggie, while we're on this, you're a Libra? Yes. Renee
so
and I are
we?
Libras.
What?
Yeah. It's a good pairing.
Good pairing.
Did you say that at the same time?
We did. Believe it or not, that was unplanned. Hilarious. This next song we're going to play for you is called Hand in Hand. We get a little bit quirky. If we weren't already.
Is that okay with you all?
We enjoy each other's company. We like to spend time talking over tea. You think you have me with a smile and a wink. I look away and tell you not to think.
Too hard. Walking hand in hand, walking, walking, step by step. Walking, walking, hand in hand, walking, walking, step by step. Walking, walking, hand in hand, walking, walking, ready, set, and go. We walk to the park with my hand in yours. It's not really something that we've done before. You ask me if I like you and I say I do. I do want to ask you if you like to slow down. Cause it's a sore spot. I'm sorry that I kissed you little more. I had too much to drink and your touch felt good. Whoa!
Walking, thank you. Had a feeling you were all a bunch of weirdos as well. So we've been doing a little bit of touring around and playing shows, and one of the things we really love about getting to do this is just connecting with people around hopeful, joyful energy. And this next song is called High Hopes, and it was written just thinking about the people who are in the world running out of hope, maybe kind of struggling alone, and what we can do to kind of notice and hang on. And it's really this dance between the tension of feeling that fatigue and loneliness and isolation and loss, and not letting those things overpower hopefulness and joy, and finding a way to hold space for all of those things, even though it's hard to do. It's called High Hopes. We like, hope you like it.
We like, hope you like it.
Yeah.
see what it's like.
There's a part at the end. We'll invite you to sing with us, okay? Okay. Okay, back to sincere.
Everybody's talking about keeping heads above water. I knew someone's daughter. Pretty much drowned. Pray she run out of road before she run out of road. There's a feather in his cap. He can't remember why. His father told him that it's there to help him fly.
Your part. It's just O, and it goes like this.
Singing.
special thing to hear all of your voices coming back. Thank you.
So the next song we're going to play is called Wrong Side of Life, and it's kind of in a similar vein as that last one. Yeah, it's just kind of about looking out for people who are wandering the outskirts and intentionally bringing them in. You know what I mean?
Happy birthday, Doug. You're on the right side of life, man. Right side of life.
Stage wife 3 months ago. Now there's vodka on his breath and his story left untold. But he'll dance in the street and sway to the beat of our song. People are hurting and pushed away, told they're wrong. Do seen, but he didn't blink, and it caught me off guard. At the end of his meal, a single tear fell from his face. How could I let my fear let me make that mistake? Do you know what it's like to live on the wrong side of life? And you let go what you know, leave judgment alone. And what if we're wrong here, bending to be right, in line all the time? And what if we're lost here, anxious every night, getting harder to decide where I belong this time?
Thank you.
It's hard that I was going to laugh and I was humming and I just kind of glued my bottom lip to my teeth instead of my lips to my lips. Sometimes I look at them and they just make me chuckle.
So we have what you might call an unconventional job, where we don't have regular weekends and stuff like that. We tend to work in the evenings and on weekends, and so we feel like we are living this kind of opposite week schedule to some other people. Does anyone else have a job that's like that? Or are you?
Probably working okay. Right now too.
Perhaps.
Yeah, true.
So this idea that like wanting to have relationships with people that are living in the regular world can sometimes be challenging. And having a job like ours where we're on the road a lot and we are busy on the times that other people are free, it's something to balance. But Renee wrote this song about how let's live for the weekend that we do have, and that's Sunday to Tuesday. Might be different than other people's, but we still got one.
Sorry, one sec.
As I was saying.
Happy birthday, Doug.
really quick story while she's tuning. Getting here to Colorado, we left Detroit yesterday. We were the closest maybe anyone has ever been to missing a flight. We raced through that airport, and it was a long way. And I was told by the gate people, because I got there first, we've already given away your seats. I'm sorry.
It was literally like one of those movies where, like, you know how Indiana Jones slides under the gate as it's closing?
Just like that.
Except as I arrived to the gate, I tripped over a pilot's luggage and like fumbled over myself, picking up my own things, dropping flip-flops.
I totally used my whip to grab the door and open it.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Your shoe to keep the door open.
For our next emotional tune.
You can't laugh right when I'm gonna.
Sunday to Tuesday. Sunday to Tuesday.
Thanks.
Thank you. We want you to know we mean that wholeheartedly every time we say it, those thank yous. Couldn't do this without you. Couldn't do this without you being born, Doug. Happy birthday. Couldn't do this without all of you being friends with Doug on his birthday and wanting to come out.
Couldn't do it without you either, George, making us sound nice. Thanks, George.
George on sound.
This is a brand new tune that we'll share with you now. Sometimes it feels demanding. Most things in my life I ask or like offer as an invitation. And this is the one space where it's like, I'm going to do this. And there is a door. Nobody likes it. Anyways.
To literally the nicest crowd.
I know. So this song is called A Really Good Bad Day. And I wrote it a few weeks ago. I just kept having these encounters with friends and family members who were just going through it, you know, and having a really hard time, and just finding some kind of strength and resilience in what they were facing in that moment. And there's this thing in me that I couldn't ignore, the resiliency that I kept seeing in all of these people. And it just got me really thinking about the contrast between pain and pleasure and all of those things that we just have to experience as humans. It doesn't always get to be these like rosy, shiny, awesome days. And I think you all know this. That's what kind of makes it all worth it, right? And those conversations about learning how to be witness to the pain that we experience and how really when you remove all that emotion from it, it's quite a mind-blowing thing that we're all here doing, right? Life.
There's this line in here that says, if you're lucky, you'll get older. And I really like that. It hit me hard when Renee sang this song to us for the first time. We're lucky to sing it with her, and we couldn't wait to unveil it. So forgive any mistakes, and happy birthday, Doug.
He was 8 pounds then, he's 87 today, and he sits on my lap in the very same way, and I'm singing a sad song I wrote that day on our living room floor, knowing life would change. Morning dove, she's here singing along, and without her I would be singing alone. I've been learning life in more ways than right and wrong. Yeah, we had our time, it just wasn't long. If you're lucky, you'll get older. Your heart will break and you'll know the pain of being human on a really good bad day. Mm-hmm.
these feelings, it comes and it goes, and seasons change. I've been afraid of growing old, eh? Birds still sing, tune their song to mine. Together on a rock, we fling through outer space and time. If you're lucky, you'll get older. Your heart will break, and you'll know the pain of being human on a really good bad day. It's okay to cry.
I dream one day we'll all be fine. Find a deeper meaning and stop
wishing away time. And if you're lucky, you'll get older. Your heart will break. You'll know the pain of being human. Oh, if you're lucky, you'll get older. Your heart will break, and you'll know the pain of being human on a really good bad day. On a really good bad day.
Thank you. Thanks. We've made a new album. Thanks. Thank you.
You didn't miss a beat, even, whoever that was.
I don't
we
even
made
know if you've
a
heard
new
it
album.
That's fantastic. Also, I've been meaning to, sorry, Renee, I totally interrupted.
In that quirky song where we like leveled up on the quirkiness, y'all remember what I'm talking about? You know the pause in the beginning? So many of you I could hear like tap your toe in the beat.
Yeah.
And y'all were dead on time. That's splendid. Nothing harder than playing along to a crowd that's clapping at the like wrong at different times. Yeah? So hard. And it's like not even offbeat per se, it's like it's like syncopated and random and drunk. Thank you.
Not only do we have a new album, we have the vinyl with us.
This song's called Find Your Way, and the new album is called When Will We Find Our Way. Was there something you were going to say, Renee?
It's all been said.
We called it out too soon. My love, it pushed me running afraid from you. Feel
Thanks so much. I know a lot of these are probably new to most of you. Do you want to hear another new one? This one's called Gray Again. And, yep, we're just going to play it. Up here, though.
Open when music played, every city street turned in. It's dusk but feels like dawn, our footsteps on the rocky lawn. They come for me when I can hear. Birds fly into the wind, they ride the wave back down again. They struggle for a sweet relief. One more day, another round, one more day, another spin. Every black and white thing that I thought gray again. Okay, I'll turn every black and white thing that I thought gray again. Trees hold a flexible, bending bones, they won't let go. How much can one thing take? For three straight days, I ring him down and wash the land in the water's own crooked edge. They held an ancient home. Mr. Lady, lady them, somebody sweet, show me love, cause I'm coming up for air again. For one more day, another hour, one more day, another spin. Every black and white thing that I thought gray again. Trying hard to get it right. The wise one told the kind one truth, uncovering the needed proof. The leaders are both wrong and right. Okay, I'll turn every black and white thing that I thought gray again. Okay, I'll turn every black and white thing. Every black and white thing that I thought gray again.
Thank you.
Want to do easier, or sorry, asleep and superhuman, or Annie's?
Yeah, we're having three a band more. Meeting.
Sometimes we end up talking too much.
And we are storytellers, and sometimes we get a little wrapped up in the other side of things. Do you want to hear another story? I'm just gonna introduce us again. This is Renee.
Hello. Thank you.
This is Noel. Both Coughlins. I'm Hillary.
She's a Leo, guys. This is Hillary.
I accept it.
They're identical twins, if you haven't noticed. And I'm a twin myself, and that is why we call ourselves the Pairs. I love that. Every time we say it, it all makes sense. We were so confused before.
Especially because we only ever play as a trio or a five piece.
We're full of mystery.
Yeah. While we're not playing music, back home I work with a team of educators and researchers and thinkers, I guess, and artists with a large organization that has about 18 different early learning centers across the city. And part of the team that I work with, the role for us is to work side by side with educators who are kind of trying to reshape curriculum and how we teach young people. And we're really trying to move from something that is compliance and conformity based to something more creative and innovative and intuitive, I guess. And yeah. One of the things that I'm always really captivated by in that work is the young children that I get to hang around. And most of them are under 5 years old that I get to visit with. And I think they're extra wonderful because they've not been tainted by social norms and kind of restricted into these very limiting roles and ideas about what it means to belong. And so I think we, as grown-ups, it's a really great opportunity to rethink the way we want to be human in the world by listening to these very young people who speak their mind. And this song is called Annie's Daughter. I don't know what's happening. Capo issues. This song is called Annie's Daughter. And it was inspired by those young children who are extra tenacious and extra rowdy and extra push back on boundaries, because I think they are the ones who we will actually listen to and notice ourselves being too rigid. I also recognize that if you are an adult who works with or loves and wants to bring up a child or have been that child, that that's a real challenging place to be given the systems and structures that we currently exist within. So I wanted to just put a song out there that said to the adults, the kids will be okay. Maybe we just need to be okay and be with ourselves and let things change, you know? Change the system, not the humans. All right. Ready? I'll get off my soapbox now and sing the song. I appreciate your ears and your claps. You're fabulous. Happy birthday, Doug.
Crowd, he tries to tell her where her miss is. Annie's daughter isn't broken. Somebody ought to tell her to her first grade class, cause they've been walking over her life. She's been shattered into pieces that won't fall back. Skipping stones at all the miles, tingling up her hair. Now
keep talking out, and that's it. And I'm not going to tell you the tune, because in the spirit of the song, you should just let your heart move you and do whatever you want. Is that cool? Yeah, here we go.
Keep talking out, keep talking out, keep talking. Keep talking out, keep talking out.
Thank you. Thanks for singing.
We got two more songs for ya. Does that sound okay?
We're gonna play one, and then I have something to say, and then our friend is there's a surprise, and then we're gonna play one more. I'm like this close to Hillary's face.
Just trust me. So do you guys remember the pandemic? Sorry to bring that up. You're having such a nice time. Well, this song, as many of our songs tonight, came from that time, because it was a creative time at home with our guitars. Me and my partner had the brilliant idea of packing ourselves up in a 22-foot trailer and driving to the other side of the country during a pandemic, which sounds very romantic and beautiful, but it's a very small space for two people living together for the first time ever. And we didn't really know anyone. So anyways, I lost this job. We all lost this job, but I'm talking about, the story's about me right now.
She's a Leo.
They like to remind me. So yeah, this, it was hard. I was also bartending, and I lost that at the same time. So within the matter of a week, we canceled the tour. All my bartending shifts were canceled. And drove across the country, and I just had this one person in my life whose business was booming. And so he was getting up at 5 a.m. every morning to get started on time, and he was working away, and I was sleeping in. And this song is about that, feeling like the world is passing me by. And everyone else is just going on, keeping on.
I really want to matter. I really want to care. I want to build something with my bare hands, and I want you all to stare. Forget that I made a promise. Forget that I hold the key. Forget that I've been here before, and I forget. So far away, you're halfway done your life's work, and it's not even half through the day. My dreams keep me from waking, the bleary-eyed wishing for more. Yeah, I can hear hard to see you succeeding, and that doesn't feel good to say. You said it before, and you'll say it again. It's just me getting in my own way.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
While we invite Doug onto the stage, there's a song I wanted to sing that you all know.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Doug. Happy birthday to you.
We also just want to say, and make Doug a little uncomfortable here, but he's like one of the kindest, most generous people we've ever had the privilege of working with, and it's a real treat, Doug. You go above and beyond to make us feel so, so valued, and we're grateful to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Noelle, Hillary, Renee. Thank you, George. It sounds wonderful out there. I wish you could be out there hearing it. I appreciate the people who came by because it was my birthday. There's a little bit of a ploy in that, but it's also a great chance to celebrate, even though the flip side is it's hard in a large group to say hello to everyone. So we'll be around afterwards. There's cookies. I also appreciate people came from the neighborhood, partly, you know, they may not just be here to celebrate with me, but rather they saw in the neighborhood newspaper, they heard at the neighborhood meeting that we were doing this. Curtis Park is one of Denver's oldest neighborhoods, and we live in a modern house, but I often picture some of your homes, maybe previous owners, maybe you've done this since you moved in, parlor music, you know, the places even smaller than this, smaller than our house, where people come and listen to musicians. And part of the reason we do this is to be entertained, and part of this is to, you know, kind of pay it forward and support them. So those of you who have been in our living room know that the instead of passing the hat, we put the fishbowl out, and everything that ends up in it at the end of the night ends up with the pears. As they travel along, we can help them along their way, and so that was my last ask, besides come on out and celebrate with us, and thanking again the Savoy for this wonderful space and the hospitality. Thanks for supporting the pairs, and thank you guys again. It's gonna be great to see you in Lions, and hopefully we'll see you on this stage again one day. Thank you. Oh. There's a merch table back there. Sometimes they hang out there afterwards, and that's where this will be.
Thanks, Doug.
We will absolutely hang out and would love to chat with you. You've just been so kind and listened to us tell our stories and share songs. We'd love to get to know you too. And yeah, here's the last tune. It's called Superhuman.
Pent up energy in the form of a hot mess, in the form of a blinding light, double taking my perfect sight. Enter my ego into every moment. How? Pander to my feelings, forget any reason. How? I guess I better let this one go. Strongly, but it's just strong chaos. Is that how I come across? And I lay down at night, it's fizzling out, but it can't seem to stop. It's in my head, but I can't articulate. I guess I better let this one go. Strength and she will. Stubborn as an ox, yeah, I've heard it.
Stubborn to the core.
I apologize, I'm sorry.
You say that too much.
I'm sorry.
You say that too much.
Without causing any big stir, without pissing anyone off. Flow with my waterfall, turn with my moon. Rise with my tide and go out again soon. You learn pretty quick, I don't got it figured out. Floors full of eggshells blocking your way out. Superhuman strength, and I got superhuman strength, and she will.
Thank you so much. Happy birthday, Dad.
Thank you again. It's been a real treat. You're all wonderful. You're very, very kind to us. Does this mean the same thing here as it does back home? Okay, we would love to play another song. Would love to, love to. Thank you so much for that. Appreciate it.
If you remember, we did a lot of running yesterday in the airport, so we're just saving our steps by going off, coming back on.
Hill's just going to detune the guitar. We're going to play you a song called Poison Water. And it's a nice upbeat message to leave you all on. No, we really like playing this song, singing this song together. Yeah, it's about, do you ever feel like sometimes you walk out of the house and you're like, yeah, I've been doing my self-work and I did what I needed to this morning to like open my heart up and do all the things to make you feel good and grounded, right? And then you enter into a room or you get on a bus or whatever, you get in the tour van
And then suddenly you're just like, oh, what is that? That just like swarmed me. It's like other people's feelings. You know what I mean? Sometimes it's hard to stay grounded and focused on what we want. I'm learning through many podcasts, it's called emotional agility. Anyway, song's called Poison Water. You all have left us feeling very, very lovely today. Thank you. We appreciate you big time. Thanks to the Savoy for having all of us in your space.
I go through my day ticking and all, and everything's in my way.
Everything is in my way.
I will carry it with me until the end of every day.
End of every day.
End of every day.
Thank you so much.
salty magic place. If you find yourself going under,